Well, she's known as the parent whisperer. And for a generation of new parents, Dr. Becky Kennedy is the calm voice helping them navigate everything from tantrums to sibling rivalry and the bond with their kids while they do it.
To be a sturdy leader for our kids, to empathize with their emotions, but not to be taken over by them. Let's think about this by thinking about being on a plane. You're in the passenger cabin and it's very turbulent. Here's pilot number one. Everyone stop screaming back there. There's nothing to be scared of. You're being ridiculous. Be quiet now. This doesn't soothe me. I actually am worried the pilot doesn't notice the turbulence. Pilot two. Everyone has to stop screaming. Your screaming is making me nervous and I can't focus. I don't know. Anyone back there want to pilot the plane? Now I'm not even scared of the turbulence. I'm just scared that this person is the pilot. Here's pilot three, the sturdy leader. I hear everyone feels very nervous back there. I hear some screams. That's okay. You're allowed to be nervous. You're right, it is pretty turbulent right now. I've piloted through lots of turbulence before. I know what I'm doing, and I know we're going to arrive safely. There's a boundary, there's empathy, there's validation. That's being a sturdy leader.
Oh. Oh, there we go. Yeah, and Dr. Becky joins us now from New York. Dr. Becky, thanks so much for joining us this morning. Your approach to parenting is a combination of validation and empathy. How does that look like? Well, what does that look like on a day-to-day basis?
So what I would want to add to that, because I think it's often missed, is validation, empathy, and boundaries. So there is nothing soft about the good inside approach. So as an example, your kid really wants to watch another TV show after you've already told them only one more episode, and you know it's just time for them to transition to bed. So how would this work to be a sturdy leader with all of those elements? I might say, oh, I know it's so hard to end screen time for me too, right? I'm validating, I'm empathizing. And then I'd say, if it's really hard for you to turn off the TV, I will come over and take the remote control and turn it off because TV time is over, sweetie. That's my boundary. Now, even if my kid has a protest or cries, I repeat that job again. I know it's so hard. We're going to get through this. You can tell me what TV show you want to watch tomorrow. I'm holding the boundary, but I'm still seeing my kid as a real person with real feelings that need to be acknowledged.
Dr. Becky, there's a whole generation of parents who are told, like us, who are told to embrace timeouts and things like the naughty step. What's your view of this kind of parenting?
You know, it's what I was trained in. It's you know, when I realized I wanted to work with, more with parents, I said, I'm going to go get the best training. And I was trained in how to deliver timeouts and sticker charts and punishments and consequences. And, you know, here's what I think that approach misses, a bunch of things. Number one, any kid who's treated that way, what they really believe is, wow, I'm a bad kid. Even my parent can't tolerate being around me when I'm having a hard time. My feelings overwhelm me, but my parents don't even know what to do with me. They have to send me to a room. Number two, they miss out on a really important opportunity, the opportunity to build a skill. A kid is having a tantrum because they don't have a skill to manage that feeling. And if we want our kids to grow up into teens and adults who actually have skills to manage feelings, we have to teach those skills to them.
We can all relate to that one, yeah, for sure. Now, you're obviously quite open about the fact that parenting can be hard, and
it's
is
very
hard.
Yeah,
and it's very, very hard. And you often talk about mum rage, dad rage. We've all experienced that at some stage as well. Do you have a tip for when it all gets just too much?
So many tips. How much time do we have? Well, first of all, I think the thing I love about the good inside approach is it's not an approach to make parenting easy. It's an approach to give you clarity, to make you feel empowered, and to make moments feel hard instead of impossible or spiraling us into an abyss. And that's a huge difference. So one of the things I think is important if you're having a lot of rage or reactivity is to start to look at the boundary side of the parental job. If we're having a lot of reactivity and rage, we might have a difficult time setting boundaries for ourselves, saying, hey, am I sleeping in the morning I need to sleep in on the weekend? Am I telling my kid tonight someone else is putting you down, maybe my partner, so I can go out to dinner with my friends? Because I need to do that as a human being, and I have the right to do that. So that's where I'd start to do the work first.
I think what makes parenting tricky sometimes as well is the intergenerational parenting tips. I think the previous generation wants to pass on what worked for them and so on and so on. I think millennial parents seem to get a bit of a bad rap, accused, people like us, accused of being on our phones all the time, not paying any attention to our kids. What do you think about that?
So one of the things I do think, and I put myself in this category, I'm definitely not above this, is what kids want more than anything and what they need to feel safest, which means, guess what, better behavior, is they need to feel connected to us. And there have never been so many opportunities as a parent to disconnect from our kids, right? If our kids want our attachment and connection, it is pretty often, even in my house, that when they're looking at me, they're probably looking at the back of my phone in between us. And so what I'd say is we all have moments on our phone. We all are distracted by our phones. And if we can do 5 minutes a day or 5 minutes every other day of something I call PNP time with our kids, play no phone, just play with your kids without your phone in the room and say, I'm having my phone out of the room because I know it's distracting and I want to give you my full attention. Every part of listening and tantrums and hitting and sibling rivalry, it always improves because kids feel connected to us.
Right on. And you also use the catchphrase, two things are true, a lot. What exactly does that mean? I mean, how do parents use it?
I think we can use it in so many ways, right? And so many times when we're in a power struggle with our kids, it's because we're in a one thing is true mentality. We can't see our perspective and our kids' perspective. So, for example, I might say to my son, no, sweetie, you can't have a sleepover tonight. You had a sleepover last night, but whatever my reason is, or just no, sweetie, we're not going to have a sleepover. But where two things are true is powerful is if I say instead, you know what? Two things are true. I'm in charge of this decision, and the answer is no for a sleepover tonight. You're in charge of your feelings, and I get that that feels annoying to you, and I think we'll figure out another night to make this happen. So two things are true allows me to assert my decision and see someone else's perspective. I don't have to agree with the perspective to see it, and I don't have to let my kid's perspective change my decision. I just need to see both at the same time, and people feel really respected and soothed when we do that.
You're so calm and practical, yeah. Becky. Do you ever lose your cool? Are your kids perfect?
Oh, my goodness. I'm in my office right now. My kids are home. I'm my best parent when I'm away from my kids. I'm such a good parent right now. Of course I do. I talk about that all the time. There is no such thing as a perfect parent. I wouldn't wish Dr. Becky on my kids because they don't have Dr. Becky as a parent. They have Becky. Dr. Becky would be a creepy, weirdo parent, okay? So, yes, I have my triggers. And what my husband always says, he's like, I hope everyone knows that you love talking about triggers and resilience, not because you're an expert at them, but because you are just on a journey of working on those things yourself. And that is 100% true.
Yeah. My kid used two things are true on me. Like, what do you mean two things are true?
You can find more parenting advice in Dr. Becky's new book. It's called Good Inside, and her website, goodinside.com. Dr. Becky, thank you for chatting with us. We're going to apply this newfound information and see how we go.
I'll go home now.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Take care.